couple of songs.
Oh yeah.
And then Ricky's gonna pray for us. Okay?
Boom. Amen.
When the Savior calls, I will answer. When he calls for me, I will hear. When the Savior calls, I will answer. I'll be somewhere listening for my name.
Help us to be able to soak up this time. Help us to look around and remember this time, God, that no matter when or where we go, God, we will always always have the memory of being able to witness an incredible miracle in this baptism.
Amen.
Thank you for Jesus. May we live our lives one day at a time, whether teen, whether married, single, campus, regardless, God, to glorify you.
Yes.
Thank you so much for the faith of Ron and Tracy.
Yes.
Help us be able to imitate their heroism, their convictions, and their love for you.
Okay.
We love you. We thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Woo! Yeah. Woo!
Yesterday, I've known you since you were 6 years old. But as the movement was being started, meeting in your house, and then I remember helping you guys move in, and then within a few weeks move out. First you moved down to Los Angeles. I remember within the first year of the church meeting in your guys' living room in Buena Park. I remember visiting at your house in Riverside. Primarily physically, but also spiritually as well, now seeing you become a disciple. I'm very proud of you. I know that being a disciple is not easy, all the more as a teen. And a scripture that I want to read you, Acts chapter 20, verse 22, that I want to read you to give you faith and courage.
Come on.
Paul, speaking to the elders of Ephesus, says, "And now, compelled by the Spirit, I am going to Mayfair High School.
Yeah.
Wow.
Not knowing what will happen to me there, I only know that in every city the Holy Spirit warns me that prison and hardship are facing me. However, I consider my life worth nothing to me. My only aim is to finish the race and complete the task the Lord Jesus has given me, the task of testifying to the good news of God's grace." And many may think this scripture is not appropriate because of the prison and hardship and yet I think nothing could be more appropriate for this hour. High school very much can feel like a prison.
Yes.
You, for the next, you're a sophomore, the next a junior, the next 2 years of your life, you will you will be not necessarily in prison, but or incarcerated, but you will be encamped in that high school, and there will be hardship, there will be trials, but I put before you, Dylan, that, that one of the things that Paul knew would come, but did not mention that moment, was that miracles would come.
Wow.
That Paul would preach before kings, that he would do things that no one would have thought possible, and it all started with his gratitude to be a disciple. It started with his desire to preach what? Heaven? No. God's grace. To preach the cross. To preach Christ crucified. And just a deep love for what God had done for him. You're so talented. I mean, you're so much more talented than me or as Ron put it to himself, but different talent. You can skateboard.
Yeah.
I mean, Stacy was shocked when he saw you skateboarding. You're so talented. And yet I wanna fill you with faith and courage that high school is challenging, and yet you know that your brothers everywhere around the world are enduring suffering.
Yeah.
And yet, with faith and courage, there will be hardship, but there will be miracles. There will be miracles that when you finish that at that high school and you go on to go into college and whatnot, I put before you that faithful, just be motivated by the cross, and just preach God's grace and his love, and help them become disciples. You're not going to leave Mayfair the same way you came in. No. You're going to leave there with a teen ministry that's in the double digits. You're going to leave there having done things that you did not believe was possible. Yes, it was prison. Yes, there was hardship. But God will work for you. I love you. I'm proud of you. Do a great job.
Dylan, I think just the one thing that hits me about you is your physical maturity. Just really in the last year, how much you've changed, even when you all come out this week. And just even watching you a couple of weeks ago in the men's midweek, your grit and your determination, you did not want to give up in that contest. And I think now to see the spiritual maturity is so amazing. And I think that the one thing just to impress upon you to have you consider is just your character. Knowing that God has called you, and to just develop your character, be open to it, and just continue to grow, and just let your life be for God, and for nothing else, and just to understand the opportunities you have before you, and what you've been given, and the family that you're going to come into is just absolutely amazing. It's the best thing in the planet.
Yes. Yeah,
I love
that's
you
right.
Lot.
I think when it comes to you, one of the
qualities that really led you to probably finally study the Bible, and God to honor them, is your ability and your desire to serve. I remember going over to your house multiple times, and you or your brother would take all the kids upstairs, you take them to the park, you would take them into your room. And that's not a task that gets a lot of credit, that's not a task that gets a lot of publicity. Whether you're taking them to the park just to show them your skateboard moves and Chase being all excited, your little ollie or whatever you're doing in that parking lot. And I think it's one thing that as you get baptized, never lose. Never being scared to do the little things that no one sees. Never being scared to just serve people and love people. And I think that's one of the things that's always about you. Like you just sincerely love people. You take care of people. It's not like a task. It's not like, well, I'm going to do it if certain people ask me. I remember plenty of times during service, you just take the kids on your own. You'd be running around the spot in Bethesda like all the time with the kids. Or taking Chase to show me new video games. That's just a quality that Jesus really, you know, embodied himself. And I look forward to seeing what you're going to do, man. A man who's willing to serve is a powerful man. And I look forward to see what God's going to do with you, bro. If you can do little things, God's got big things for you, bro. So before I love you and before I give you a hug, I'll let my wife share.
Thanks. So Dylan, it was so funny. I was just telling another disciple this couple days ago. For you, I always thought it was a win. It wasn't if. I wasn't going to ask. It was just a win. I was like, this kid's going to become a disciple. That's it. And I think for you, the thing that stands out the most to me is your perseverance. I watch you in D.C. and you just kept going, kept pushing, kept your grades up when everything was going crazy around you. And you stayed joyful and steadfast, like you're a bedrock. And that's what all disciples will need anywhere you go, any ministry that you're doing. So I'm not even worried about you as a team, because I know you know how to do this already. You know how to persevere in the midst of adversity. You know how to keep your head up. You know how to make amazing, wonderful friendships that you keep for a lifetime. And people are very loyal to you because you're so loving. So God's giving you a lot of gifts in terms of your character as well that I know that will last a lifetime. So I'm so proud of you.
Come on, you.
Changing coast. just the instability of life sometimes. I mean, it's hard on us as adults to see what you've gone through, but to see you persevere and just to see all the challenges that's gone on in your life and your family, making the right decision, taking the right decision,
change our life, and
And you guys were the first friends to our kids. And I'm always going to be super grateful for just the journey. And journeys have peaks and valleys. And it has been so, so great to watch you grow up. I do remember the little pool that you guys would swim in. And I also, kind of like Lindsay, I knew you'd become a disciple. Like, you've always been so good-hearted. And we have loved you like our own. And I just really love the fact that we got to spend time with you guys in D.C. and how you embraced Brandon during a really rough time. And you guys really took care of him. And I'm just really, really proud of you. I can't wait to see who you're going to become. And I know it's just going to be great. And I am looking forward to just watching you grow even more in the kingdom. Call you my brother, but we will always be there for you as well. So I love you so much. And before I hug you, I'll
Well, I mean, it's kind of weird standing here. Like the first time I met you, you were like, you know, a little kid, like literally a little kid, 10 years ago, hanging out with Brandon, wanting to play video games, and you know, you would want to just come and hang out and watch movies and all that stuff. But through it all, like, I always knew that there was something special, you know, about you. You got mad skateboard skills, you know, and like meeting me and your dad. I mean, your whole family. Like, you could just see. Everybody knew, like, you were going to become a disciple, whatever it took, you know, through whatever challenges that God would allow you guys to go through. But I just know that there are awesome things that are going to come from your guys' family. I mean, just the perseverance, just the love, just the, you know, just the heart to want to do the right thing for God. And then just seeing, you know, it's hard being a teen, but now the teens here in L.A., they have an entire ministry wrap their arms around you. So you're set for success. You know, you're going to start a Bible talk in your school. You're going to start baptizing people in your school. So it's going to get easier in one sense. You're going to have partners. But just in the long run, I know God is going to do amazing things for you. You know, by the time you go to college, you know, wherever, whatever mission team we send you to lead, you know, we know it's going to be hot. And we know you're going to just bring a lot of glory to God. But I'm super proud of you. Literally like a son, you and Devin. You know, I love you guys. You guys are always welcome at our place, and I'm just so proud of you.
Awesome. I'm going to let a couple of the guys that have been in their lives and studies share. I'm going to let Gordo share, and then we'll have Gordo and Stacy here.
Well, Dylan, I'm so proud of you, dude. Just like Ricky, I've known you since you're 6 years old, and I even got to live with you guys, and when we lived in Portland, and there is something special about you. Even in through these last 10 years, at every GLC, you would always come up to me and look for me and find me and give me just a loving hug. And that's so encouraging, bro. But just one scripture I want to share with you is the scripture I shared at my baptism when I got baptized. Is do not let anybody look down on you because you are young, but set an example. And if you hold on tight to the scripture, bro, you're going to be able to help out so many teens. Teens even in the LA church are going to be able to look up to you, even though you've recently gotten baptized. But I'm very proud of you. I'm excited for you. I love you with all my heart.
I'm so proud of you. You know, I think you're so talented. You know, you're... The scripture comes to my mind. 1 Samuel 16:12, it says, "So he sent for him and had him brought in. He was glowing with health and had a fine appearance and handsome features." That was David. Kind of reminds me of you, right?
Oh.
I was very fortunate because Dylan asked me to be in a Bible study, and I was like, but I'm older, you know, like, you know. But I was incredibly impressed by your heart for God. I mean, Dylan's 16 years old. He was talking about, "I just want to be right with God." He was just getting all the sin out. I'm like, "Wait, hold on. There's going to be time for that."
Right.
But he just wanted to get it all out. He just wanted to get it all out. Awesome. He wanted to be right with God. And the great thing about God is the Bible says that God, man looks at appearances, man looks at stature, but God looks at the heart. And your heart is golden, my boy. I'm your uncle. Yes. I'm fired up for that. I'm so grateful that you skateboard. It gives me a chance to go out and skate with you a little bit and just have fellowship. But I'm proud of you, man. Like, I'll always be here for you and your family. You're my boy, man. I love you.
Come on. texting back and forth. And when I first saw you, you were kind of like in the back row, like a lot of Kingdom kids are back row, arms crossed, on your phone, earbuds in. And I was like, oh boy, another one of the typical Kingdom kids. We're going to have to work on it right here. And, you know, and then we just started texting. And then Mason texted me, he was like, Dylan is studying. No, Ronnie texted me, Dylan is studying the Bible. I think I was in the middle of math class or something. And I was like, I read it. I was like, oh, I was fired up. They were studying the Bible. And
Jesse, I was that guy that was like, Dylan, you gonna study the Bible? He was this guy, kid sitting in the back with his headphones on. I was like, you know what, I'm gonna just befriend this guy. I remember 2 months ago, we sat in Dylan's room playing like maybe an hour of video games. And I was like, did you ever think about studying the Bible? And he gave me the most parting answer I've ever heard in my life. He was like, you know what, can I be honest with you? He's like, I wanna, before I become a disciple, I wanna make sure that I wanna be. Yeah. And the scripture that really reminded me of that was in Psalms 119, it says, blessed are those whose ways are blameless, who walk according to the law of the Lord. Blessed are those who keep his statutes and seek him with all his heart. And this scripture reminds me of you because you embedded so much. Just the times that you served me when I was there. Kenneth, do you want something to drink? Kenneth, do you need this? Kenneth, do you need that?
And I'm
this dude's not even a disciple yet, and he serves like one.
Wow.
And you really just invented that energy of just loving people. You know, even though sometimes you're like, get away from me, you really were like, you just adopted me as like a brother. And I was like, man, I'm super grateful for it. And bro, I'm so proud of you, man. Like, I was, man, I just sitting there watching you go through it. Like, I want to study the Bible. I want to get through this. I want to do this for not just for myself, but for my family. And so, bro, I really am proud of you, bro. I commend you, and I look up to you. So I love you, man, and just wait to see God do.
Yeah.
Get baptized, you know. he's my little angel. He's only just awesome, Dylan. And, I mean, you didn't have to share with me. You didn't have to share with me your stuff, but wow, you went through some stuff, baby, but it got you to the cross.
Yeah.
Come on. It's hard for us parents to watch our kids go through darkness.
Yeah.
But they got to go through it.
Yeah.
And you went through it, Dylan, and I didn't have no idea, you know. And, but I know God's going to do great things through you because you're going to appreciate that cross, right?
Yeah.
And I know you're going to stay firm. Yeah. Because we're here. We're not going nowhere. This is your family.
Come on.
Look at the Portland crew here, the DC crew here, the City of Angels Church is here. Come
on. Yeah.
Know the truth.
Right.
And today's your turn.
Come on.
And I remember holding you when you came out of your mom's belly and your heart was beating at 10 beats a minute. We thought we were going to lose you. And I've watched you grow up into such an incredible woman.
Yeah.
Man.
I have one scripture for you.
Okay.
It's in Ephesians chapter 6. The Bible says, children, obey your parents in the Lord.
Oh, yes. Yes.
For this is right.
Go on, bro.
I like that one.
Go on.
I like that one.
Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on earth.
Yeah.
I'll stop before the father, don't exasperate your kids part. But I read that scripture because... I know in the book of Malachi, God says, if I'm a father, where is the honor duty? Where is the respect? And I read all that not to be funny, but Dylan is the only teenager that I've ever known. Never once in his entire life has he ever disrespected me. Never once has he talked back or thrown an attitude or a temper tantrum. And everyone keeps saying that you're so special. That is what's so special about you. I know the Bible says to be all things to all men, but as I watch you, I marvel at the way you give your heart. You have the ability to connect at a heart level with a child through the teens, the campus kids, the singles. And I see you even engage with the older people, and you connect with everyone easily.
Yep.
I only know one other person on the planet like me. Your mother's very much the Lord. I know you got that from her, not from the Lord. But I do marvel at the way you serve. It was incredible last week to see you jump in, help set up sound, and Dylan has asked to be my partner in cyber ministry.
Nice.
That's a very special. Very special. I would have never known that you sinned. I did know, but when I saw your sin list, I go, amen. He's gonna really appreciate the cross. And yet, I think when I watched you as you studied, right after seeking God, you got all your sin out right at the first study.
Yeah.
And you just kept getting in touch with more sin and confessing more as you got in touch with it.
Awesome.
And I so respect your heart. One of the incredible things that Dylan did is that, we've given up a lot over the years.
Yep.
My career, different moves, and all of that.
Come on, Ron.
And I know it was a source of bitterness for you for a long time, because every time we sacrificed, it became your sacrifice.
Yeah.
And I was so moved this week when we came from church and we're collecting extra money for special missions. And I know the teens were asked to do $100. And what Dylan shared with me when we went home, he says, "Dad, I can easily get $200. And I was like, "Okay, how are you going to do that?" He goes, "I'm just going to sell my Xbox One." And boom, he sold it for $200
Come
2 days
on.
Later. And, I'm so proud of you. Devin has phenomenal, incredible gifts. I'm so proud of him. And you have your incredible gifts.
That's right.
But, God has plans that none of us can fathom for you.
That's right.
You'll have the ability to connect with more people than I could ever hope to be able to connect.
Come on.
And I love you with all my heart. And I can't wait to get out there tomorrow.
Come on.
Thank you so much, because without you, I wouldn't be here right now, and my dad wouldn't be in the church.
and none of this would have happened, so I thank you so much. Devin, I just want to thank you so much. Like, even if you don't even remember, you saved my life. And I wouldn't even be here right now if you wouldn't have saved my life. And it's hard. Like, I was like, I knew I was going to die right there. And you stuck your hand in there and tried to save me. And you did. I just want to thank you so much. And yeah, that's what I have
to say. For those of you who don't know that inside joke, Dylan fell into a river. And Devin jumped in and saved me. I know, but on behalf of the family, Yaman, Stacy, Aleem, Mason, Kenneth, Ricky, thank you so much. Jordan, and come on, Ron.
Come on, Ron.
I know when the Chiapettas came, I saw Luke at staff meeting. And I about hounded him the whole staff meeting to get in there with Devin, I mean with Dylan, and Dylan blew him off. Kip and Elena, thank you so much for being there with us, pulling us back into the, you know, so we can start this movement. Tim and Leanne, we love you with all of our heart. Thank you so much for teaching us and training us here in LA. Jesse and Lindsay, some of our very best friends, we thank you so much for moving here with us. And Rob and Berg, Michael and Sharon. It's an incredible thing to be a part of God's kingdom.
That's right. Yeah. Come on.
And, you know, this baptism is just as much all of you and your involvement as anything that we've ever done. And of course, most of all, you know, we want to thank our God.
Yes.
Yeah. So at this time, let's go to God in prayer. And then we'll ask the questions. And we will go ahead. Father, thank you so much that you always have such a phenomenal plan for us. Mm. You've known Dylan since before he was in Tracy's womb.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you formed him, Father, for this moment. But you formed him for so much greater. I pray that you will keep him faithful all the days of his life.
Amen.
God, that he will never turn from you, never leave you. That he will understand that you will never leave him or turn away from him.
Yeah.
And that you will always be with him. Help him to do things that all of us could just dream of doing.
Yes,
God.
And impact this world in phenomenal ways. We thank you for being a part of your kingdom.
Yes.
We thank you for loving us. Yes. And we thank you that you sent your son. You did.
Yes.
You had the ultimate sacrifice so that we could all be here
today.
Right.
Yeah.
And it is in his name that we pray.
Amen. Yes.
Well, Dylan?
All right, Dylan, I got the two most important questions.
Come on.
Dylan, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God? He died on the cross for your sins. Was resurrected on the third day.
Yeah.
What is your good confession?
Jesus is Lord. Yeah. Yeah.